B-Monster Laboratory here. Today I'm going to show you how easy it is for absolutely anyone to add voice control to an Arduino project. I'm going to give you an introduction to MOVI. Who's going to win the AFC Championship?
Please tell me both teams. And don't tell me the Patriots are playing.
You can purchase this for $75 on Amazon. You can also go to their website, audeme.com. I'll link that in the description below. I think the price is pretty much the same there as well. And by the end of the video, you're going to see how awesome this shield really is. I think you're going to like it. We'll go ahead and do an introduction to the MOVI shield, and we'll take a look at a couple of the beginner example code that they include in the library. So let's begin.
Well, this is MOVI, M-O-V-I. It stands for My Own Voice Interface. And it is a voice control shield for Arduino boards. And you can use a number of the Arduino boards. I would recommend using the Elegoo Uno version 3 or the Mega version 3, just because that's what I'm familiar with. But you can use the Leonardo and some of the other ones, and they may take some modifications. By modifications, I mean you might have to remove or leave in place the jumper that goes right there on those two pins. But we'll talk about that in just a second. I want to say, why would you even want a MOVI voice control shield? Well, the shield allows full sentence voice commands for tasks like turning devices on and off, entering alarm codes and passwords, and carrying on program conversations with projects, which is probably my favorite. And I do like this one. It is standalone, meaning it's not on the cloud or the internet. It's not like Alexa, scanning the internet, reading Wikipedia, sending data back and forth. So I do like that option. And it is easy to program. If you're new to this, new to Arduino, or never used it before, they do have quite a number of example code to get you started, and they're very useful as well. And you can give MOVI a voice of a male or female. You can also have MOVI whisper and do a couple other things as well. So that is another very neat option. And there's plenty of space if you want to customize your sentences. They mention in their PDF document that they've tested up to 200 in English. Well, this is what I'm using. I'm using, on the left, you see the shield, the MOVI shield, and on the right, the Arduino Uno. This is version 3. Now, if you take a look at the shield after you place it on your Uno or your Mega board, you'll notice that it doesn't completely set all the way down into the headers, and it works fine. Although I didn't think it would, but it does work fine. There's contact, so that is okay. Under here, you can see the SD card, and that SD card, I do not believe, is replaceable. I think if you break it or lose it, I think you have to get a new one or buy a new board. I don't know, but you have to leave that in there. You can't expand it, I don't think. This one is an 8GB SD card. So as far as the shield goes, you should be familiar with a couple of things that are on here, such as the microphone, and you can see that at the top right. Also the indicator LED, and the mic in jack, and the audio out jack. And over on the left side, jumper number 1. Depending on what board you use, you may need to keep that closed, or you may need to open it. And also the reset button, which is right above that. So in case you're wondering, MOVI is now fully compatible with Raspberry Pi 3, and you can use the C++ library or the Python library. But if you do use the Raspberry Pi with this, you will need an adapter, so you'll need to look that up. So the first thing we want to talk about here is the power supply. You'll notice that there is no option to plug into the shield, and that is because the power comes from the Arduino board, and it requires external power. So you need to plug in your external power first before you ever plug in your USB power, because it can't run off USB power, and the external power needs to be between 7 volts and 16 volts at least 500 milliamp current. And I use the wall adapter that came with my Elegoo kit, and it is 9 volts at 1 amp, and it works just perfectly. And I've also used a 9 volt battery here, and that works just as well. So when you're plugging in your power, remember to plug in the external power first, then plug in your USB, and also when you remove the power supply, remove the USB first and then remove your external power. As for speakers, I use a 3.5 millimeter audio cable. I put it right here in the audio jack on my shield and connect it to my soundbar here. It's just an old soundbar, and you can use the MOVI library to control the volume, but it's just easier using the volume control on your speakers. Now, you don't have to use speakers. You can just use regular earbuds into your headphone jack here. I find this to be quite loud. I use the really cheap bargain pair of Sony headphones here that was only $10. Now, when it comes to the microphone, you can use the built-in microphone right here. I read in the PDF file that it can reach up to 15 feet in a room. That is probably a room without any noise at all. If the room is too noisy, MOVI will let you know. MOVI will say that there's too much noise in the room. What I use is a lapel mic. It works very nice. There's plenty of slack, so I don't have to worry about whether or not the onboard microphone can hear me. And if you choose to use a lapel mic or another mic attached to the microphone jack here, just keep in mind that it will disable the integrated microphone. Now, about the LED, there are some things that you should know about the LED. The LED is right here. When it's blinking fast, that means that MOVI Shield is booting. If you see random blinking, that means that MOVI's writing to the SD card, also called training. If you upload a new example code, or you write your own code and you're uploading it to the card, it'll blink. So when the LED light is burning solid and it's always on, not blinking, MOVI is ready to operate, and at that point you can unplug your USB. The reset button is right here, and one quick press will reboot MOVI, but if you hold it down and it's a long press, it will revert back to factory settings. Now, the jumpers are down here, and this is jumper one right here. I have removed jumper one. On most boards, jumper one must be open. Jumper one only needs to be closed when a 5-volt board is used that does not have an IO ref pin. And as you can see as an example here, Arduino Uno R2, which is an older board, and R1 do not have an IO ref pin located where the arrow is. And if you take a look at the newer R3, they do have an IO ref pin. So if you don't have that pin, the jumper needs to be in place. Jumper one hardwires the 5-volt pin to the IO ref. And if you set the jumper one on a 3.3 volt board, you'll destroy your board. So keep that in mind. Now it's time to plug in the soundbar. I'm going to plug that into the headphone jack here. Now I'm going to plug the lapel mic into the microphone jack. Now it's time to plug in the 9 volt wall adapter, which I showed you earlier. And once you plug it in, you should see the LED start to blink faster and faster. Once it burns solid, that means it's time to plug in the USB cable. And we'll go ahead and plug in the USB cable. And now it's time to download the MOVI library. In order to download the library, come up here to Tools, go down to Manage Libraries. A little window will pop open right here, and you just type in MOVI, M-O-V-I. Not sure why my screen keeps doing that. And as you do that, these will load up here, these libraries. And you can see MOVI Voice Dialog Shield, which I already have installed. It'll look like that right there. You click on Install. So install that, close it out. Then to open some of the example code, you come up here to File and come down to Examples, and then it should be right here in this list since we just downloaded it. MOVI Voice Dialog Shield, you can go to Beginner and Light Switch. And this is where we'll begin.
MOVI booting. MOVI is ready. The call sign is Arduino. Push to talk example. Push button and speak.
In this basic example, when the sentences are recognized, they switch on and off the LED on pin 13. Many boards have a hardwired LED on board already connected to 13. I went ahead and put a actual green LED in pin 13 and connected it to ground right next to it. This one's pretty simple. We come down here, the call sign is Arduino, and we're going to say let there be light, and the light will come on, and when we say go dark, the light will go off. That's all this one does. Click on upload. It's uploading. Then you'll see the LED flicker on the board.
MOVI is learning new sentences.
There
it is. Please do not unplug the power. Training finished. Unplugging is safe. One moment, please. MOVI is ready. The call sign is Arduino.
Arduino. Let there be light.
And there was light.
Arduino. Go dark. This LED was on pin 13, but we can put it on any pin we want, and we can even use multiple LEDs. We can also change that to operate servo motors and even operate lamps through the use of relays, like 5-volt relay. So there are a lot of options here. And next we'll just go up and look at the next beginner example code. So we'll go to File, Example, go down to MOVI Voice Shield Dialog, or Voice Dialog Shield, go to Beginner Light Switch 2, we'll open that one up. This is an alternate version of the light switch demo that uses one sentence and stores the state of the light in a variable, and this is useful to cut down on the sentences to be recognized if you have a larger project. So we come down here and we can say Arduino light, and the light will come on, and then good night, and the light will go off. So it's much shorter, well, a little bit shorter anyway, and we'll go ahead and give it a try. So we'll upload it. While it's uploading, I'll switch over here. Looks like we have a problem. First thing I always do is Arduino. That should be right. Yep. Port. Oh. You know what? It's a little bit embarrassing. Plug that in. Alright. Let's try this again. Upload. While it's uploading, I'll switch over.
MOVI is learning new sentences. Please do not unplug the power. Training finished. Unplugging is safe. One moment, please. MOVI is ready. The call sign is Arduino.
Arduino. Light.
And there was light.
Arduino. Good night.
Good night.
You have to use the call sign Arduino. Arduino. Light.
And there was light.
Good night. Good night. Arduino. Good night.
Good night.
So from here, we'll do one more of the example beginner code. We'll go up here to File and Examples. Go down to MOVI Beginner Light Switch 3. And we'll open this up. This is another alternate version.
There is a lot of noise in the room.
It's a lot of noise in the room. This is another alternate version of the light switch that shows us how to use command to prompt a user. And the dialog looks like this right here. The user says Arduino, it beeps, you say light, and the Arduino will say on or off, and you say on or off. So let's give it a try. Arduino, light,
on or off,
on.
And there was light.
Arduino. light off. Off.
Good night.
Jumped the gun on that one too quick. But it worked. You have to wait until Arduino is done speaking, and I did not at that time. But we scroll down here, and we can see the code. It's still on pin 13. Again, you can make that any pin you want. And for the LED. And you can use other components as well. We'll do that in future videos. And down here is the code. You can see the call sign is Arduino. And then here are the words for the commands and the question. So that is three different examples.
Well, that's all I've got for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to like it by clicking the thumbs up. Also consider subscribing to the channel and clicking that bell notification button. I've interacted with a number of you through comments and emails, and you guys are awesome. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you again very soon.